The batch limit is the limit, 59% of the energy that we can capture from the wind. Now, if you allow the actuator disc to become a rotor disc that's spinning at some rotor speed omega, the side effect of doing that is that you add a swirl to the downstream wind. So adding a swirl means you have to pay for it. Agree with that? You have to pay for it with momentum and energy. Or in other words, that side effect of the method that makes you adding that swirl is that you cannot capture as much energy as in the actuator disc model. So we will get something that is less than the batch limit for sure. The question is, how much is that?